Hi students, welcome back to today's class. Now we are going to see stack. This is also one of the data structure available in Python. Okay, so stack is a linear structure implemented in last in first out. So you know what is meant by linear structure. Linear structure in the sense continuously like this, the values are going to be arranged either from left to right or from top to bottom or from bottom to top. Okay, bottom to top or top to bottom. Or right to left like that in any linear structure. Okay, so a stack is a linear structure implemented in last in first out. Okay, so which element is inserted last, that is going to be removed out of first. Okay, so that element is going to be removed first from the out of the stack. Okay, that's why it is called as last in first out. Or we can write like this also, first in last out. So which element is inserted first, that is going to be removed last only. Okay, so like that we can say the stack structure. So stack is a linear structure implemented in last in first out manner, where insertions and deletions are restricted to occur only at the one end. So only at the one end insertions and deletions are going to be happen in the stack. Okay, so that is stack's top only. So top of the stack, see here, the top only the insertion and deletion is going to take in place in case of a stack. So LIFO means element last inserted would be the first one to be deleted. So which element we have inserted last, that is the thing is going to be removed, deleted first. Thus we can say that a stack is a list of data that follows these rules. So stack means what? It contains list of data that follows the following rules. First one, data can only be removed from the top. That is pop operation if you are performing. Pop means removal of element. Okay, so when you are performing pop operation, data can only be removed from the top, that is the element at the top of the stack. The removal of element from a stack is technically called a pop operation. So from the stack, whatever elements we are removing, that removal of element from a stack is technically known as pop operation. A new data element can only be added to the top of the stack, that is push operation. The insertion of an element in a stack is technically called a push operation. Okay, so there are two operations we can perform on the stack. There is push and pop. Push is for insertion and pop is for deletion. We should not say delete or insert. Okay, so we should use the terms, technical terms in stack, like for insertion, push operation, and for deletion, pop. We need to say like that. Okay, so initially the stack will be empty. So that is indicated with the help of top is equal to none. So none is one of the data type we have studied as a basic data type in Python. So none is the empty, it is used to represent empty value, not zero. It is used to represent empty value. So top is equal to none, that means there is no element in the stack initially. Then in the second step, we are going to push 32. Push means element is going to be inserted into the stack from the top. Okay, so 32 is inserted here at the as a top element. And then we are pushing 18. So 18 also pushed here like this, how this arrow is pointed here, no dotted arrow. So same manner, the element is going to be pushed from the top of the stack. There is no bottom, there is no place to enter the value in case of stack. Okay. And then pop one element. That means immediately the element which is placed at the top only is going to be removed. Okay. We cannot remove which element we want to remove from the stack, no, like that we cannot remove any element from the stack. So only the top element is going to be removed. So pop, that is 18 is going to be popped now. Then push 29 is going to be pushed to the top of the stack, and then again we are popping the 29. Okay, notice that all stack operation, that is push or pop, takes place at one end of the stack is known as stack top. Okay, so stack operations names are push and pop. So stack is a linear list implemented. So it is a linear list. It is implemented in LIFO, that is last in first out manner, where insertion and deletions are restricted to occur only at the one end, that is stack top. Okay. So it is a linear list implemented in LIFO manner, where the insertion and deletions are restricted to occur only at the one end, that is stack top. Okay. The stack is a dynamic data structure as it can grow. Okay, dynamic in the sense it can able to grow in its size. Okay, with increase in number of elements. So when the number of elements is going to be increased, the stack size will get incremented. Okay, it will grow. Okay, are shrink. Shrink means reduced. Okay, so with a decrease in number of elements, when the number of elements is going to be less, automatically we can able to reduce the stack size. Okay, so like that, stack can also be dynamic data structure. Yeah, static data structure, how it will work means, on the other hand, is the one that has a fixed size. Okay, so stack will be stack can be used as dynamic data structure also, and it can be implemented like static data structure also. Static data structure in the sense, the elements, the container, like a container, no, the maximum size will be there. Okay, so that is a fixed size. So in that size only we can fill all the elements. Okay, that is a static one. Okay, dynamic means we can increase the size of the container or a stack. So that's why it is called dynamic. Okay, we can according to the number of elements, no, when it is increased, we can increase the length of or size of the stack. Okay, and when the number of elements are less, we can shrink the stack size. Okay, so that is only known as dynamic data structure. Then other stack terms, okay, other terms what and all we can use, other than this push and pop operations, and we can use the following terms, that is related terms that are related to stack: peak and overflow, underflow. Peak, comma, overflow and underflow. We will see what is mean by peak and overflow and underflow. Peak means it refers to inspection, that is inspecting the value at the stack store without removing it. So without removing the value which are available and the at the stack top, we are going to just inspect the value, whether the value is available or not, just we are inspecting. So it refers to inspecting the value at the stack top without removing it or deleting it. It is also sometimes referred to as inspection. And then overflow, it refers to situation, that is error. Okay, this also, underflow also, when error occurs, which kind of error means, we will discuss that. So it refers to situation, that is error, when one person is trying to push an item in the stack when it is full. Okay, when it is full, and in that case, if you are trying to push in an element, this situation occurs when the size of the stack is fixed. Okay, when we are using static data structure, in that case, it cannot grow further, or there is no memory left to accommodate new item. So there is no memory available in order to accommodate or in order to hold the get the new item. In that case, this overflow occurs. So overflow will be occurring in under static data structure only. When you are going for static data structure, in that case, overflow condition will occur when we are trying to push the element when the stack size is full. Okay, and underflow, when it occurs, this is extremely opposite to overflow. That is, when there is no element in the stack, if you are trying to find out some element or pop some element, then in that case underflow will occur. It refers to situation or error when one person tries to pop or delete an item from an empty stack. Already the stack is empty. In that case, if you are going to delete some item, what will happen? Underflow error occur. That is, stack is currently having no item and still one tries to pop an item. So the technical terms for insertion in a stack and deletion from a stack are push and pop respectively. So insertion in a stack, how we can call in a stack? Push. Okay, so deletion from stack is otherwise called as pop. So we will consider one example here. Consider some example illustrating stack functioning in limited size stack. Okay, please note, the stack have bound fixed the capacity of the stack for understanding purposes. So here we are going to assume the stack size is fixed one. Okay, so that is a static stack structure we are using here. So first example, given a bounded stack of capacity 4, so the stack capacity here is what? Only 4, which is initially empty. So initially it is indicating empty only. Draw the pictures of the stack after every following steps. So first step after, you need to draw the picture, and initially the stack is empty. That is also they have given. So initially we need to draw when the stack is empty. In the first case, top will be pointing to none only. Okay, so top is equal to assigned to none. Okay, in none, when you are writing none, the N should be capital. Okay, N, and the true or false, when you are writing in Boolean data type, the T also should be capital, and false also, the F should be capital. Okay. So stack is empty, so top is assigned to none. So 0, 1, 2, 3. So totally how many number of elements are there in this stack? Only 4 elements we can folder. So the stack capacity is 4 only. So like that, you need to draw a figure. That is only 4 boxes you need to draw here. And then second point is what? Push A. So after pushing A, the top will be now pointing to which index value? 0. Okay. And then third step, push B. After pushing B, top will be now it is pointing to 1. Then push C. The fourth operation is push C. So top will be pointing to 2 now. Then pop. Pop means top will be decremented. Okay. So that is the size minus the. Now currently it is indicating 2. So 2 minus 1. Okay. Stack of top minus 1 is what? Stack of top is now 2. 2 minus 1 is 1. So it is pointing to now B. Okay. See, you can look at the arrow also. And in the seventh step, okay, in the seventh step, you are popping. Okay, that means D is going to be removed out. Okay, the sixth step, you are pushing D here. Now top will be pointing to 2. In seventh step, we are popping D. So D will be removed out of the place and the top will be pointing to 1. And then push E. So top will be now pointing to 2. In that location, E is placed now. Now we are pushing F, that will be placed at the third index. Now top will be pointing to 3rd and push G, overflow occurs. So because there is no size, memory is fully occupied. So the stack size is fully occupied already with some elements so that overflow condition will occur. So overflow, because the stack is bounded, because bounded means it's already fixed for some size. Okay, it is a static one. It cannot grow. If it could grow, no, then there would be have been no overflow until no memory is left. That means if it is able to grow, then there would have been no overflow until no memory is left. That is, when the memory is available, we can store some more elements also. Okay, when it is able to grow, no, when the stack is able to grow, in that case we can add some more elements also until there is no memory is left. That means until memory is available, we can move the elements or we can store the elements. When the memory capacity is not there, okay, in that case we cannot add the elements even for the growing side also. Okay, and next one, in Python, for stack implemented through list, since list can grow. Okay, so if you want to implement stack concept, no, in Python, so it is going to be implemented using the linear list because it will grow easily. So it can grow, and overflow condition does not arise until all the memory is exhausted. That means until the memory is available, we can add the n number of elements. When the memory is exhausted, we cannot add any elements after that. Okay, so for that reason only, in Python, stack operations or stack is going to be implemented in the concept of list. Okay, so now ninth condition is what? We need to pop the element, so F is going to be removed now. 11th one, F is moved, pop operation. And then 12th one, again pop operation, E is going to be removed. And 13th one, again pop, top is now pointing to 0. Okay. And 14th one, again pop, A is also moved out. Now top is pointing to none. Now we are going to perform pop operation again. So that in that case, there is no element in the, there is no, top is pointing to none, there is no element. So stack is now empty. In that case, underflow condition occurs. Okay, this error will occur. Now implementing stack in Python. So how we can implement the stack concept, that is stack data structure in Python, let us see now. We are going to use the following methods, following functions in order to make a stack, okay, implement the stack operation in Python. So in Python, you can use lists to implement the stack. So we are going to use the lists or arrays, linear list, or we can say array to implement the stack. Python offers us a convenient set of methods to operate list as a stack, okay. So in order to operate a list as a stack, it is going to give a set of functions or methods. Okay, methods means what here? Methods means functions only, like append, pop, like that. Function names we are going to use. It is providing those functions in order to operate a list as a stack here. So for various stack operations, we can use list. Let us say list name as stack and use Python code as described below. Okay, so list is going to be now considered as a stack. In the name of stack, we are taking the list. Okay, so we can use stack of top. Okay, stack of top in order to find out the inspect the top element. Okay, so top is an integer having value equal to len of stack size. That is len of stack size means stack minus one means what? Length of stack, that is number of elements which are available in the stack minus one, that will be assigned to top. That will be assigned to top. So top is equal to length of stack minus one. Next is push operation. In order to insert any element into the stack, what operation we need to perform, what method we need to use means stack name dot append. Stack name, that is list name dot, okay, list name dot append. We need to append item, okay, which item we want to enter, that is 10 or 20 or 30, like that, any element or characters if you want to insert to the stack, that also you can pass it through the item, okay, the name, variable name, item. And then pop, we can use stack name dot pop. Okay, the stack within less than and greater than square bracket, sorry, less than and greater than symbol, inside stack is placed. No, that stack is indicating the name of the linear list. Okay, so whatever name you are using for making a array or a linear list, that name only going to be used here in the stacks place. Okay, so stack dot pop, opening and closing parenthesis. Here no need to mention the element or item. Okay, only for appending you need to mention the item. Okay, that is the value what you are entering, that should be given here in this append operation. Okay, append function. Now let us now implement a stack of numbers through a program. Okay, so now we are going to define the function push, that is stack comma item. So we will see Python program to implement the stack operation. So stack implemented as a list here. Top is indicating what? Integer having a position of topmost element in the stack. Okay, always top will be used to indicate the topmost element in the stack. Now initially one function we are writing here, one function definition, always we need to check. Okay, whenever we are performing insertion or deletion any kind of operations, if you are performing, that is for displaying any elements, okay, in that case we need to check whether the stack is empty or not. Okay, so def is empty of stack we are writing if stack is equal to, that is the array name is what, list name is stack, list name is what, stk here. Okay, this is used here as formal parameter. So if stk equal to square bracket, that is initially it is assigned to null, none. Okay, when it is empty it will return true. Whether it is empty or not we are checking. If it is empty, what it will return, it will return true only. No, true boolean value will be returned here. And else, if condition is not true, then automatically it will go to else part, it will return false. That is, there is some element in the stack. Okay, so like that we need to check for which operations, insertion and deletion operations and all, we need to check it properly. Okay, now even for peak also we need to use this is empty function. And then pop also we have used, and display also we have used. So like that in four places we need to use the is empty, we need to call that is empty function. Okay, now we are going to main part. Okay, we will go to main part. After that we will go to which function it is called, not to that function we can go directly. Now main program we have went. Initially stack is empty, that is stack is assigned with only square bracket, that means it is indicating there is no element in the stack now. So stack is equal to square bracket, what it indicates, it indicates there is no element in the stack. And top is going to be assigned as none. Okay, so in that n should be capital. Okay, none is the empty data type. Now while true, that means always you need to consider the condition while is true always, that means always these operations are going to be performed displayed in a screen in a continuous way. Okay, so when you give while true, so every time until you give exit, every time this print stack operation push pop peak display, this values, no, is going to be printed. Okay, these statements are going to be printed in the screen and you are giving while true. So we have given while true, that means condition is always true here. And CH is equal to, so when you want to perform the operation push, you need to give character as 1, that is CH value as 1. Okay, in the integer value you need to pass here, that is choice of operations, no, you need to give. So here how many choices we have given? 5 choices. First choice is push operation, second choice is pop operation, third choice is peek, that is to inspect the top value of the stack, and fourth one is you need to display the entire stack elements, and after that fifth operation is just you come out of the program. Okay, that is exit. Okay, that is the fifth operation. Now we are going to get the choice from the user. Okay, if you entered 1, so condition we are checking here, if elif later here we are using, so if CH is equal to 1, that means push operation. So you need to get the element. Okay, if you want to push an item, you need to get the item value, no? So item is equal to int of input of enter item. So that stack, that is stack is now initially empty, that stack along with item is going to be passed through this function, that is function name is what, push. So push of stack comma item. So here actual arguments are stack and item, that is going to be copied here in the function name. See here, see the function name is here push. So that stack, stack stack, we have used in actual argument in the main program, no, that is going to be copied here. Though now stack is empty, and item what we have passed, so item, for example, if you are pushing 10 element, 10 means 10 is copied here. So stk dot, what is the operation we have studied in the previous push operation? See, this is the format. Okay, syntax stack dot append of item. See, the same thing, stack name. So stack name here is what, stk here. So stk dot append of item. So this always you just remember this, actual parameter and formal parameter names should not be same. Okay, see here we have used stack here, stack and item, but here we need to use what, different name only we need to use in the function definition. So stk and item is same name only we have used here, but the value is going to be copied here in the formal parameter. So item is 10. So stk dot append of item, that is 10 is going to be inserted. Append means it will be inserted in the stack. Now top will be pointing to length of stk minus 1. So what is the length of stk now? Length of stk now is 1. 1 minus 1 is 0. So top is now pointing to 0. So next one, okay, after see like this, one by one only, one element only at a time we can insert. Okay, then after that, second case, if you are entering second choice, okay, what will happen? Elif CH is equal to 2. What is the second choice? Pop operation. So item is equal to pop of stack. That means immediately the stack is going to be passed here and the pop function is called here, and the returned result will be assigned to this item. So which item we have removed, that item is assigned to other item. So pop of stack, see here that stack is fully copied here. So now the stack is having only one element, that is 10. Okay, and immediately it is checking the condition whether it is empty or not, because when you are performing pop operation, if it is empty, you need to return underflow answer. Okay, so for that immediately we are calling isEmpty function. Okay, so from this function we are calling another function. This is also a pop, is also one function only. From this function we are calling another function, that is isEmpty, isEmpty of stack. If it is true, you need to return underflow, because we cannot perform pop, so automatically underflow only will occur. Okay, else we need to pop the item. Okay, so isEmpty of stack is what it is written here, is empty of stack. Whether stack is empty or not, it will be checked here. No, else part only will be coming, so return false. So if it is false, automatically where it will go? Else part. So item is equal to stk of stk dot pop. Okay, that means the 10 is also popped out now. Now if len of stk is equal to 0, so what is the len of stk? Stk is 0. Yes, sir. Yes, only, no, len of stk is 0 only, no. So now top is going to be assigned to none, because only one element, 10 only was there. The 10 we have removed now. Len of stack is what? 0 only now. So top is now going to be assigned to none. Else, if you have two elements, so what will happen? Len of stack will not be zero, it will be one. So if it is one means len of stack minus one, zero will be assigned to top now. Then return item, return item. So item should be returned here. So that is what? Top will be now pointing to none and the item is going to be returned, okay? Next one is third choice. See here, third choice is peak, just to inspect the value. So if value is available or not also, we need to do the isempty function. We need to call the isempty function. So for peak, what is given? Let us check now. So see here, the item is copied here now. If item is underflow, what answer we have returned from there? We have returned from there as popped item. Okay, so popped item is going to be displayed here. So item is not equal to underflow, so it will go to else part. So 10 is popped now. Okay, so the 10 will be getting printed now. Okay, now third choice. What is the third choice? We need to call peak function. So peak of stack. Stack only here also we are passing. We are not passing item. So only in the case of push operation, we are passing the item. For display and for peak and for pop, every function we are just sending the stack values only, stack list only. Okay, so item is equal to peak of stack we are sending. So see, it will go to peak of stack here. Okay, so that entire stack is copied now. So now 10 is removed, you know, in the previous case. What is the stack value now? Top is none now. Okay, if is empty of stack, we are checking. Yes, it is empty now. Okay, so it will return underflow only. So is stk of stk is equal to opening and closing square bracket empty value or not? It is checking. Yes, it is true. So what will happen? If it is true, it will return underflow. Else, it will mention top is equal to length of stk minus one and return stk of top. Okay, return the top value is going to be returned. That is, index value is going to be returned here. If there is any element, if it is available at the top, if there is no element, it will be returning underflow. Now under this case, 10 is already popped out, so there is no element, so it will return what only? Underflow only. See here, now that return underflow is copied to this item. If item is equal to underflow, it is checking. Yes, item is also underflow, here also underflow, so it will print underflow, stack is empty. Otherwise top mode, otherwise it will print what? If 10 is available, then length of stk minus 1 is what? 0. The topmost item is that item name 10 is going to be printed here. Understood? Now fourth choice we are entering, display of stack. Okay, just it will go and check whether it is empty or not. Okay, so display of stk if is empty of stack. If stack is empty, it will print stack is empty. Else top is assigned to len of stk minus 1. That is, len of stk is what? If only 10 is there, so length of stk is only 1. So 1 minus 1, 0. So top is 0 now. So that is pointed by this top. The arrow is pointing to now stk of top. That is, stk of top is now what? 10. So 10 is now pointed by top. Then remaining elements, if it is available in the stack now, that is going to be printed with the help of this for loop. So initial value, then this is the step value, then this is stop value. Okay, initial, stop and step value. Okay, so like that we have given the values. So top minus one is now, top minus one is what? Now only one element means only this first print statement alone will get printed, and then print of stka will not get printed because we have already assigned the top element. So if you have around four elements, it will be printed by using this for loop and this print statement. Now let us see the output of this. Okay, then you will understand. Then the last choices, if you are entering the choice as 5, so what will happen? Invalid choice. Okay, so if CH is equal to 5, it will come out of the program. If it sees break statement, automatically it will come out of the program, and else it will give invalid choice. If you are not entering correct choice, no, if you are entering 6 or 7 like that, then invalid choice like that, it will get printed. Okay, so now stack operations. First you are entering choice 1, you are entering item 6. Next operation also push only, 4 you have entered, and then 6 you have entered, and then 8 you have entered, and then you are entering choice 4 now. Okay, So what will happen? Now it is pointing to top, that is 4. The remaining elements, whatever we have entered, that is displayed here, one after other using that for loop. Okay. So this is display, fourth choice. Okay. And now first choice, again 2 is entered. Then for third choice, see here, topmost item is 4. Like that, third choice is printing only the topmost element value. Okay. So that is peak. Peak value is printed after giving this 3. So like this, you can write the program using list. Okay. If you want to implement stack operations, like push, pop, peak, and these are the main 3 operations, and display, along and then exit. All these 5 you want to perform here or implement here in the stack using the linear list or array, you can write the above program what we have discussed till now. So with this, we will end up this today's class, and in the next class we will see the remaining the stack implementations in a detailed way.